Come in, don't be shy. Have a seat. I want to tell you about the computer that I built for the Socket A build-off. First off, it's a Sempron 3000 Plus. The motherboard is an ASUS motherboard, but was originally an HP OEM board that I managed to flash the BIOS on and update. Second of all, I decided to go in a complete different direction, and I've installed Windows Vista Ultimate Edition on this computer. Now, what makes that special? I'll tell you what makes it special. What makes it special is what you're watching now, which is Windows Media Center Edition for Windows Vista. And back in the day, Windows Vista, by the way, back in the day, that allowed a person to use a TV tuner, much like this one. This is my Haupage. It's an ATSC or digital TV tuner. However, the drivers don't seem currently up to snuff, or the USB ports on this computer is just not giving it enough juice, because when I install this, it tends to turn itself off at random times. So we're not doing any live TV. Plus, we have the whole copyright thing. So what we are doing is we're watching one of my videos in Windows Media Center Edition on the projection screen. And I am projecting this with an Epson home media projector, and it's being projected at 720p, which is the lowest resolution you can call HD. I have owned this projector for quite a few years, and it's still pretty mint. It probably doesn't have 1,000 hours on the light bulb. So, I really wanted to put TV on this computer to show it off, but I can't. However, we're watching a video, and I'm going to fire up a couple seconds of Brazil, which is kind of one of my retro favorite movies to occasionally watch, because every time I watch it, I get a little bit more out of it. Who doesn't love a dystopian future, right? Not like we live in one right now. So sit back, relax, enjoy Windows Media Center Edition. Please subscribe and like if you like what I've done here. I've gone as far as I can whole hog on this retro build. I'm pleased that the Socket A build-off has been as popular as it is, and I can't wait to see some of my competitors' builds. Thank you, friends, so much. Uncle Mike, out.
Hi there. I want to talk to you about ducts. Do your ducts seem old-fashioned? Out of date? Central Services new duct designs are now available in hundreds of different colors to suit your individual taste. Hurry now, while stocks last, to your nearest Central Services showroom. Designer colors to suit your demanding taste.
I've already shown the case, and this was the old gamer's case from a rescued Pentium 4 at the salvage yard. I wanted to go over the hardware I'm going to use for this Socket A build. And first off, the motherboard. I am using my HP OEM variant of the ASUS A7V8X board, and it has a Sempron 3000 on it, and I'm using 1 gig of DDR 333 megabyte RAM. So not the 400, because this chipset I have on this board does not support the 400, but it's 333 memory. And again, the Sempron 3000. I'm going to see if the onboard audio is sufficient for the task loading the VIA 4-in-1 drivers. So I'm going to stick with that. For video, I am going with an ATI Radeon 9600 DV. So it's a digital video edition. 256 megs of RAM. And it's a beauty. I haven't tested it yet. It was another salvage yard rescue. But it's a good looking card. And it's in keeping with the era of the motherboard. Finally, for storage purposes, I'm going to throw in a Seagate, a Barracuda 120 gig drive. And it is IDE. And then for the optical drives, as I had stated earlier, I do have a DVD drive. Actually, I have two DVD drives. One's a standard DVD-ROM, and the other one is a DVD rewrite. And then I do have the card reader, which I may or may not hook up, and then a floppy drive, all color-coordinated to the case. And this will all be serviced by the 480-watt power supply. It's a Tegan. I have no idea. I never heard of them before. I didn't even bother looking it up because it's a slick looking power supply with plenty of everything that I need. And the nice thing about this case rescue is it came with rounded ribbon cables. We have a round floppy cable and we have a round cable I'm going to use for the optical drives. I will throw in a regular hard drive cable for the hard drive. Just a standard UTA cable. And the goal now is just to put in the motherboard, throw in the hardware, make sure when I push the power button it all fires up. And then, my friends, we'll start talking about the left field that this video is going to take. The operating system and the additional hardware I'm going to put inside.